Moving on to the type of quizzes you get, it is multiple choice questions and there can be multiple answers.
Yes, in the assignment actually they will find multiple choice questions and also yes no type questions.
Yeah.
In the application packages course they will find yes no. In some other courses sometimes they will find true false instead of yes no.
That's right. So one other important thing is that after doing the quizzes they can see the marks immediately. They can see the grade they have got immediately. So let's move on to what type of quizzes they are going to get for the assignment quiz 2. Okay, let's look at some examples.
Yes, for the MCQs type of questions they will find something like just a statement. Now here for an example, what is the maximum number of characters can be entered into a text field? So it's asking the maximum number of characters that can be entered. So they see the five options there, so they can click here to answer. Multiple choice means they can answer, there may be more than one correct answer.
Yeah, so it's multiple choice and multiple answers. That's very important that the students know that it's multiple answers. There can be multiple answers.
Mm-hmm.
And then there are 10 questions, as you can see on the top of the screen. You can see the 10 questions that you need to select, and you can save without submitting. And once you are 100% sure that you have selected the correct answer, you can submit and finish and see the results immediately.
And in this question actually, from the stem of the question, they must see that whether the question is having multiple answers or single answer.
That's
now
right.
It's asking what is the maximum, that means only one answer is there.
So there is a clue given in the question as well, whether you are expecting one answer or whether there can be multiple answers. Okay, so can we look at another example?
Yes. Now in this example, actually we have given them a picture, and based on that picture we have asked something. Now is based something, this question is actually based on Excel, MS Excel, the spreadsheet applications. So here it's asking about how to fill this remainder field.
That's right. Mm-hmm. So you can take your time, because there is no time restriction, is there?
Yes, that's right. Yes.
Yeah. So what you need to do is basically answer the 10 questions without worrying about the time restriction as in other exams, in these assignments, online assignments. So moving on to another example.
Yes, this is another example that I have given there. It's a picture. Now these type of questions maybe they are in the question paper as well. So we will give them a picture and we'll ask how to format this one, how to create this one, and like that. This type of questions will be there. So in this particular one is asking what is this diagram.
That's right.
So another example shall I show you?
Yes.
Now this one is actually having a stem. In the stem we have a blank. A stem of the questions we have a blank. And by looking at the letters, the words in the neighbor, they should find the correct answer from the options given.
Okay, now will there be a problem in accessing the quizzes, or do the students know where the quizzes are, where to find the assignment and all that? Can you give us a brief description about where to find the quizzes and what you should do?
Yes, now in the assignment 1, we gave them assignment 1 at the end of the third unit, third section of the syllabus. Now here they will find it in the LMS at the end of the seventh section. So here I have given them and marked it with a circle, red circle. By clicking on this one, this link, they can access the assignment 2. And once they access the assignment 2, they can start doing it, and they will see the 10 questions and links to access the questions. So after completing the exam, now this exam actually they can attempt 3 times. So the highest grade will be taken as the grade for the assignment. Now after completing this assignment, if they want to see the score, they can go to the first page of the LMS, and from the left hand side they will see a link called grades. So by clicking on this link, they can access the grade page. So there they will see their grades listed here. So not only the assignment 2, assignment 1 grades can also be seen here, and the That's total. Right.
So all these facilities are available through the learning management system. And for external degrees, it's very important that the students have this kind of material available on the web, because the internet has become a public infrastructure which is available to anybody anywhere in the globe. So now this is the common practice. This is not a extremely difficult thing for students to do, but this is the common practice when it comes to external degree programs anywhere in the world. They use the internet and they use a learning management system type of thing to give the information and collect information from thousands of students anywhere in the world. So will there be an issue on accessing the internet for the students, because we know that only some students are using the learning management system effectively and participating and contributing to forums. So there are so many ways of accessing the internet. One is that you may have an account from home, so you have access to internet from home. The other is you can always go to a friend's house, and then if you know of so many people who are following this course, at the same time you can get together and have discussions on these things. Because for this type of application, especially application packages, you need to do the practicals. Now, as you have seen in some of the quizzes, unless you have done it at least once, you don't know how to answer the questions. So practice is very important. So you can get together with friends and have discussions on how to answer, and then find internet accessibility from there or from your office. Of course, you can get permission from your employee in order to access this kind of material in your office. And if you have access to internet, or if you go to a university or an institute, again you have access to internet there.